JJ the CPA here. Hope you're doing well. The employee retention tax credit, what quarter in 2020 do you go back and claim that credit if you haven't already? So we know that with the Consolidation Appropriations Act that came into play on 12/27 of 20, that we are able to take advantage of ERTC even if we got PPP. So I have put together a seminar. You can get instant access to it, but let me give you the answer to what this video is talking about, which is which quarter do you claim your credit? So the first thing I just want you to note is that if you've already filed everything for 2020 payroll rise, which you should have given that we are in February now, then your only option is to file a 941X. And that is the quarterly report that employers file to indicate the wages and taxes that are then collected and due and assessed and credits and all that good stuff. So I will tell you that on Form 941X, if you are only changing one quarter, and now that we're in February, I was talking to a client today and they thought that their payroll company had taken care of it. They hadn't. I said, well, the credit is in March and it's in April. And so it's in first and it's in second quarter. So on the Form 941, you find that there are instructions that indicate that you report that all then on second quarter Form 941. So you would then report that as a 941X on your second quarter. So if you though, and you're looking now at more than one quarter of employee retention tax credit, meaning it might've been in first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter, and you're thinking, well, do I need to amend all of those? Well, let's look at what the law indicates here. So in this seminar, I broke down the law. It's a 2.5 hour seminar. You get this entire PDF PowerPoint that goes through that. But down here on slide 127, this is directly from the law. And so I put the law into this. Now, for some that want to make sure, down these are all the links that you get if you attend this seminar, and the videos and its worksheets and spreadsheets and links right where you need to go. But anyway, so if we go to the Appropriations Act, and we then go to page, believe it or not, up here, 4,932, this is where this is from. So there's a special rule that we're looking at. So we're in section, if we go up to 27, we're in section 206 of the Appropriations Act. And this is going to be on page 4,932. And we have a special rule and all this. Well, to make it easier, I did put that into the seminar materials, but here's a special rule. Okay, it says effective date, boom, in general. And then here's the special rule. It says an employer who filed a return of tax with respect to applicable employment taxes, that is going to include Form 941. But it says before the date of the enactment of this act may elect. So what this is saying is if you filed for first or second or third quarter, your employment tax returns, which is Form 941, so if you filed them before the date of this enactment of this act, you may elect to treat any applicable amount as an amount paid in the calendar quarter, which includes the date of the enactment of this act. So it was enacted on December 27th, which is in fourth quarter. So what this is indicating is that if you filed tax returns for employment purposes, Form 941, before the enactment of this act, you then are able to include any and all amounts paid in the calendar quarter of the fourth quarter, because that's the date of the enactment. It then further down in here, in the same section, it says the applicable amount for purposes of subparagraph A, the applicable amount, this is all that kind of legal jargon, but it says permitted to treat as qualified wages paid in a calendar quarter beginning after December 31st, 19 and before October 1st, 2020, and not taken into account by the taxpayer in calculating the credit allowed under Section 2301A, meaning the Employee Retention Tax Credit. So when you read this, and you can pause the video here and read it for yourself, because sometimes it takes a minute. But what this is indicating is that if there are wages that are on employment forms that are in first, second, or third quarter, right? Because it says between basically the first of 2020, because it's wages after 12/31/19, and before October 1st, 2020, which is what? Third quarter. So any wages paid in first, second, or third quarter can be accounted for in fourth quarter. Now, part of what's confused, I think, a little bit is just how the IRS, this is back to this page that you can get a link and go get access to this in the video and the seminar. But up here, I gave a link to the IRS's announcement related to this, and that's where there's been some confusion. But what this indicates is that you can report it all in fourth quarter. You can read it and take a gander at it. It does also indicate, though, that you can just go back and amend the applicable quarters if you would like. So if you want to amend second and third and fourth quarter, you can. If you want to record it all in fourth quarter, you can. So when you're looking at, well, what do I want to do? I think I've given you a couple of examples there that will help you. And then in my seminar, I kind of walk through basically these various aspects of the 941 and where you put the amounts and how you go about it and what the instructions are related to this. But at the end of the day, you do want to take advantage of this credit if you are able to take advantage of it, because this is a credit that is up to $5,000 per employee. Now that's for the entire year of 2020, but while you're shut down partially or fully, it's the wages during that time. If you're 100 or less employees, it's all wages in essence. So check it out. I've got a ton of videos related to this, breaking down various aspects. And so I'll put a playlist to that, or I'll put a link to that playlist talking about these things. Now, for an in-depth 2.5-hour seminar with 3 hours of FAQs in addition to that, with that PDF that walks you through every aspect of this under the new law and retroactive, and then how you take advantage of it in 2021, check out the link to go to my seminar. But either way, make sure you're taking advantage of this credit. If you qualify, do a deep dive. This is massively valuable to so many businesses. And if you don't want to spend $97, that's fine. But go to the IRS website, put in Employee Retention Tax Credit, go to the FAQs. There's 94 of them. Go through every single FAQ. Make sure that you understand this. Go to the aspects of what the IRS has put out there, because when you go through those FAQs, you'll see the IRS time and time again shows you how you should qualify. Now, there's a bunch of rules and regulations around it, just like anything else, but don't let that bother you. Now, I will tell you, you do have time. The 941X, there's, you know, 2-3 years. Basically, know this. If you file it within 2 years, you can get it. Now, at the end of the day, you want to do this sooner rather than later. All right. Hey, thanks for tuning in. I'd love it if you subscribe. And then don't you ever forget, you've never met a CPA quite like me. All right. Have a great one.